Now we'll discuss about the very important topic, the rectus sheath. Rectus, in this diagram you have seen, this is rectus abdominis muscle and here is small muscle, this is pyramidalis muscle. This muscle is covered in a sheath. What are the arrangements of the sheath? We'll discuss in this section. Here, if you cut a transverse section at this level, you will find this is rectus abdominis muscle. Here is external oblique aponeurosis. This is external oblique aponeurosis. And here is linea alba. This is linea alba of the Giffard process. This label is Giffard process. This is Giffard process. This section is taken from above the costal margin. This is costal margin. Above the costal margin. This section is above the costal margin. Here is rectus abdominis. This muscle aponeurosis is external oblique aponeurosis. This is external oblique aponeurosis. This. And this is Giffard process. And posteriorly, here you can see 5th, 6th, 7th. These may be 3 costal cartilages. So anterior boundary is formed by external oblique aponeurosis and posterior boundary is formed by these 3 costal cartilages. This may be, which is here, to 5th, 6th, 7th costal cartilages. Another thing, if you cut a section at the level between the costal margin and here, this level is, this is arcuate line level. This is arcuate line. From here to here, if you cut a section any level, you will find this is rectus abdominis muscle. This here is external oblique aponeurosis. This is linea alba. This is linea alba. And here is internal oblique. This is internal oblique. This is external oblique. This is internal oblique. Internal oblique divided into 2 lamina. This is anterior lamina. This is posterior lamina. And this is linea alba. And posteriorly, there is transversus abdominis muscle. So this is transversus abdominis muscle, like this. So from here to here, relations are anteriorly external oblique aponeurosis, anterior lamina of internal oblique, and posteriorly posterior lamina of internal oblique and transversus abdominis muscle. And another thing, if you cut a section below this arcuate line, and that means between arcuate line and pubic bone, you will find this is rectus abdominis, and here lies pyramidalis. It's covered by, this is external oblique aponeurosis, then there is internal oblique aponeurosis, then there is transversus abdominis aponeurosis. Here you can see all 3 aponeurosis, external, internal and transverse abdominis, are lies anterior to this rectus abdominis muscle and also pyramidalis. So in this pyramidalis, here if you cut a section this level, here pyramidalis is not present. If section passes this level, then only pyramidalis is present here. So this is linea alba. So anterior lesions are these aponeurosis, and posteriorly another fascia is present, that is fascia transversalis. Here is also fascia transversalis. It is also fascia transversalis. Fascia transversalis. Fascia transversalis. If you see all these things here, this is skin, then superficial fascia, then external oblique aponeurosis. This is rectus abdominis. This covering is external oblique aponeurosis here. This is 5th, 6th, 7th costal cartilage. This level is above the costal margin. Above the costal margin. 5th, 6th, 7th costal cartilage. And here is this is transversus abdominis and internal oblique. This is transversus abdominis and posterior lamina of, it is posterior lamina of internal oblique. Here is anterior lamina of internal oblique. This is line where these posterior covering finished and formed the arcuate line. Actually, this covering here merge with this anterior side. Here this transversus abdominis also reaches here. So here you can see external oblique, internal oblique, and transversus abdominis. External, internal, and transversus abdominis aponeurosis present. And internal oblique, this is internal oblique and transversus abdominis form the conjoint tendon at the lower level here. Form the conjoint tendon. So this is external oblique. Here internal oblique and transversus abdominis both fuse from the conjoint tendon. And another thing, inner most covering is fascia transversalis. This is fascia transversalis. So if you see anterior covering, this is complete, and posterior covering is incomplete. If you see the content of this rectus sheath, there are two muscles, rectus abdominis and pyramidalis. Rectus abdominis, and in the lower part there is pyramidalis also. There is also pyramidalis. There is two artery. One is this artery. This is superior epigastric artery. And here is inferior epigastric artery. This is superior epigastric artery, which is a branch of internal thoracic artery. This is inferior epigastric artery. This is inferior epigastric artery, which is a branch of external iliac. And vein, these are the veins which accompany the artery. The superior inferior epigastric vein. And nerves, nerve in this region. These are the seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth, 11th, 12th, or subcostal nerve. So these nerves are